One of the ways that QAnon has spread so rapidly is that they organize on social media. And it's been very easy to proliferate information about this on things like YouTube and Instagram and Twitter and Snapchat and all of that. Well, Facebook is, at least they say, fighting back against this now. And so they say in a statement, "Today we are taking action against Facebook pages, groups and Instagram accounts tied to offline anarchist groups that support violent acts amidst protests, US-based militia organizations and QAnon. While we will allow people to post content that supports these movements and groups, so long as they do not otherwise violate our content policies, we will restrict their ability to organize on our platform." They say that they're gonna derank and limit algorithmic recommendations for QAnon pages, groups and accounts, remove those that discuss potential violence and ban QAnon ads and fundraising efforts altogether. And they say that so far they've removed more than 790 groups, 100 pages and 1500 ads tied to QAnon, blocked more than 300 hashtags. Well, stay on it because they're gonna get new ones in minutes. And impose restrictions on more than about 2000 groups and 440 pages on Facebook and more than 10,000 accounts on Instagram. Remember, followed by millions of people. And so Rashad, do you think, like, how big of a move is this? Is it gonna stick? What do you think about Facebook finally taking this seriously?
Well, first of all, Facebook needs to get it together. I can't believe they're bragging about those numbers. All right, 1500, 700 this, 1500 that. You're talking about millions of followers. You're talking about hundreds and hundreds of thousands of people tweeting this stuff or putting this stuff on Facebook and then sharing it and then going to their communities talking about it as if it's real. They are simply chasing their tail if they think this is the way to do it. You can't give groups like this that have an exact agenda to do exactly what they're doing. They will only reform and reformulate the strategy. That is it. Unless Facebook actually gets real serious and they eradicate this altogether. Right now, they're still playing games, in my opinion.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that, look, banning those groups makes sense. But with Facebook, anything coming and anything having to do with disinformation and especially politics, I fundamentally don't trust them. And we need years of them doing the right thing for me to fundamentally change that view. I mean, we know what they did in the run up to 2016, how much they've resisted any actual reform since then. They're still routinely allowing Donald Trump to lie in his campaign ads because it's to their financial benefit. Right. They're meeting with members of the Trump team. So, okay, you banned some groups. We'll see what we'll see in a week. We'll see in a month.
But here's what's gonna happen, John. If they don't do something now, this guy who's currently the leader of the free world, he's not going to always be the leader. The individuals who are in charge of the Senate will not always be in charge of the Senate. If they don't figure out a way to self-regulate and do a better job at it, when leadership transforms or transitions, they will be on the chopping block. Their industry will be severely regulated by law and by mandate rather than by volunteerism. And so they have a choice to make. Either get it right now or wait for the leadership change and they will get it right for you. Because the American people are getting tired of it. The vast majority of Americans polled about this, they are tired of lies on social media. It's the sentiment of the country. It's the sentiment of many elected officials. And it is the sentiment of those who are emerging to the ranks of power in this country.
Yeah. What a terrible time we live in every possible way.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.